Well, one of the highlights of the day here today has been the Merlin helicopters, which are based here at RNAS Culdrose. Of course, they're a familiar sight to many of us around the West Country. We see them in the skies around our coasts all the time. And people have been given a chance to get up close and personal with those helicopters today and sit inside and have a look around. But I went one better than that. Earlier in the week, I was given a chance to take one for a spin and have a look around their fantastic training simulator.
£190 million worth of state-of-the-art technology, the Merlin Helicopter Training Simulator at Culdrose is at the forefront of flying training, and today they're letting me have a go.
Put yourself in, make sure you're comfortable. No, well, first thing we have to do is make sure that you can reach all the controls.
Right.
My teacher is Lieutenant Commander Tony Morris, one of the experienced flying instructors here. He's taking me through all the controls, and just look at all those buttons.
Right.
So if we roll that to the right, to start with, just push it across to the right. Good.
The inside of this white bubble is an exact replica of the actual Merlin cockpit, and the graphics are amazing. The screen wraps right around you, and you can see real landmarks.
Is that the Helston River down there?
That's the Helford leading away out into Falmouth Bay with Gweek, a little village just on the nose.
Enjoying the view is one thing, but actually keeping the Merlin in a steady hover is another matter altogether.
You see very small movements required to keep it in the hover.
Yes, I can feel you moving the stick all the time.
It's moving all the time, but just a tiny, tiny amount.
Just tweaking it.
Of course, this is a really busy facility, not just for training, but also used by experienced pilots to keep their flying hours up. So it wasn't long before we had to make way for someone else to have a go.
If you want to combine all that and take us back and land us on the airfield, that would be fantastic.
Yeah, no problem.
Well, that was absolutely amazing. So realistic to be in that simulator. But now it's time to go outside and try the real thing.
The Merlin helicopter is used for surveillance, looking for things on and under the water. This one belongs to 829 Squadron, one of three squadrons based here at Culdrose. Even though my experience of flying one amounts to just those few minutes in the simulator earlier, Flight Commander Brendan Spores lets me have a go for real.
I'm actually at the controls now, I'm flying this, so hang on.
I thought I'd take the Merlin for a little spin up the coast from Culdrose to have a look at St Michael's Mount. And what an amazing view you get from the air. I flew round it three times and then somewhat reluctantly gave control back and we headed back to base.
Well, I took the controls of the simulator and that was pretty cool, but I never expected to be allowed to take control of the real thing. An absolutely amazing experience. We flew up the coast and back, and look, we're back on the ground, back on terra firma in one piece. Amazing.
Well, that was Bob's Top Gun moment, and this is mine. And from up here, you certainly get a very good idea of how huge a Merlin helicopter is. And I've been allowed up here by Charlie Parrock. You fly these things. It must be the best job in the world, isn't it?
Oh, it's a fantastic job. I'd do the job for free most days. It's just really, really gratifying.
Is it something you always wanted to do from a small child?
Yeah, from the age of from a very young age, really, at school. I always wanted to join the Navy and fly helicopters. And here
you
I am.
You say you're in the Navy, but of course, it's an RAF helicopter, isn't it?
It is. It's a Royal Air Force Squadron helicopter, newly formed, but jointly manned by Air Force and Navy personnel.
And obviously today you're having a whale of a time, aren't you? But you've just seen active service, haven't you?
Yes, I have. Just returned from Iraq about 3 weeks ago. Flying around in the desert. It's quite warm out there at the moment.
What are the worst things you've seen?
It's not so bad out there at the moment. There's a lot of peace breaking out, if you like, but obviously there are some casualties still being taken, but it's not nice for anybody.
But you're there. What's your day like?
Well, it's quite warm for a start and very dusty, and it's quite tiring. We're working very hard. But again, it's really gratifying the work we're doing because we're delivering to the troops on the front line and providing a very good service. And that's what makes it really enjoyable for me.
Best thing about the job?
Oh, well, lots of things, really. It's a very challenging, but again, quite rewarding pastime to do.